Hey there, viewers. Do you know what the pancreas does? You probably don't think about it much. I know I don't. Your pancreas is an organ located in your abdomen. Its job is to convert food you eat into fuel for the body. But problems can arise when it becomes inflamed. This is known as pancreatitis. Let's go through everything you need to know about this disease. How does it happen? What are the symptoms? What can it lead to? Can pancreatitis be treated? We're talking about all of this and more. What is pancreatitis? Like I said, pancreatitis occurs when the pancreas becomes inflamed. But there are cases that are much more serious than others. There are two types of pancreatitis you need to take note of. The first is acute pancreatitis. This is the kind that develops rather quickly and usually only lasts for days. It's very rare that acute pancreatitis develops into something serious, but it does happen. The second is chronic pancreatitis. Now, this is the one you really need to be worried about. With a chronic condition, do not expect your pancreas to get better. Chronic pancreatitis causes the organ to decline with time. As the pancreas gets worse, your body won't be able to digest food properly. While it can happen to anyone, this type of pancreatitis usually occurs among people between the ages of 30 and 40. About 275,000 people each year are diagnosed with acute pancreatitis in the United States. Chronic pancreatitis is less common, with only about 86,000 people a year, so at least that's a relief. About 1 in 5 cases of pancreatitis can be life-threatening. It all depends on whether or not your condition worsens. But we'll talk about that more in a minute. Have you ever experienced pancreatitis? How long did it take to go away? Did it only get worse with time? Sound off in the comments section and start a conversation with our bestie community. How does it happen? I'm not trying to alarm you, but there are so many different things that can lead to pancreatitis. This includes factors like your lifestyle and your personal health. Some of the main causes of both acute and chronic pancreatitis are as follows. Number 1. Obesity. If you're obese, you are much more likely to suffer from pancreatitis. This is due to the release of unsaturated fatty acids that stop the pancreas from functioning the way it should. To say obesity is an issue would be a massive understatement. The number has nearly tripled since 1975. In 2016, almost 2 billion adults were overweight. So if you're worried about your size, pancreatitis is one more thing to motivate you to get in shape. Number 2. Cigarette smoke. Smokers are 3 times more likely on average to develop chronic pancreatitis compared to non-smokers. If you're already suffering from pancreatitis, it would be wise to quit. Number 3. Alcohol consumption. This is one of the big causes. People who drink on a regular basis are much more likely to develop pancreatitis than those who take it easy. To be clear, heavy alcohol use is usually described as 4 or 5 drinks in a day. So if you're a dedicated partier, you might want to rethink your habits. Number 4. Gallstones. These are stones that form in your gallbladder. Sometimes, the gallstones will leave your gallbladder and block the link between your pancreas and small intestine. This causes your fluids to become backed up. This can be life-threatening if it's not treated. Number 5. Family history. Like so many other conditions, pancreatitis is one you may be genetically predisposed to. This is particularly true for chronic pancreatitis. If you have a close family member with pancreatitis, there is a chance you could also develop the disease somewhere down the road. That's why annual checkups are so important. What are the symptoms? If you're suffering from pancreatitis, there are so many different symptoms to watch out for. For one, there's abdomen pain. And I'm not just talking about simple discomfort in your midsection. This can range from light to severe. A lot of the time, your abdomen can hurt so bad, it begins to affect your back. This can set in right after eating and last for a while after. But keep in mind that it's more common with acute pancreatitis and will eventually go away. With chronic pancreatitis, you're likely to experience weight loss. The scary part is that it comes out of nowhere. Even when you haven't changed your appetite, you'll still notice a drop on the scale. Weight loss happens because your pancreas isn't allowing you to digest food properly. Since you're not absorbing nutrients like you normally would, you'll become malnourished. Chronic pancreatitis can also lead to nausea and vomiting, not to mention some serious diarrhea. When using the toilet, you'll notice the color of your stool is weirdly pale. Before we continue, are you trying to get in shape? You need to make sure your diet's right first. Check out our recent video on 9 most essential nutrients and why they're important. Now back to our discussion on pancreatitis. What can pancreatitis lead to? Pancreatitis can lead to some serious complications. For one, if your acute pancreatitis gets really bad, it'll result in a bacterial infection. In this case, you might require surgery to get rid of the infected tissue. There's also kidney failure to worry about, but this only happens if your condition gets extreme. The effects of pancreatitis on your body can be really scary. Did you know that it also can affect your breathing? Changes in your body's chemicals can impact the way your lungs function. Your level of oxygen becomes limited, only allowing you to take smaller breaths. On top of these issues, pancreatitis can also lead to diabetes. This is because the cells in your pancreas aren't producing insulin. And we mentioned before how you can become malnourished since your pancreas isn't absorbing any of the nutrients in your food. There's also something you may have never heard of. Let's talk about a pseudocyst for a second. This is a science term for a lesion that develops when fluid and particles collect and form pockets. Not only can they develop on your pancreas, but also your abdomen and eyes. Perhaps the most frightening complication of pancreatitis is pancreatic cancer. If the organ remains inflamed, cancer could develop. About 90 to 95% of pancreatic cancer patients die within 5 years. Keep in mind, this happens if you have chronic pancreatitis. How can you treat pancreatitis? Well, there are a few things you can do before pancreatitis even develops. Of course, it involves some pretty dramatic changes in your lifestyle. If you drink on a regular basis, stop. Alcohol does quite a number on your organs. This will only increase your chances of pancreatitis in the long run. The same goes for smoking cigarettes. Your entire body will thank you for this. You should also curb your eating habits. That means less cheeseburgers and more vegetables. If you watch your diet, you can avoid obesity. It would also be good to exercise a few times a week. That way, you're working off those extra calories. Now, if you've been diagnosed with pancreatitis, your treatment will vary depending on what kind you have. Mild cases of acute pancreatitis usually go away without treatment. But if the pain in your abdomen lasts longer than a couple of weeks, you need to talk to a doctor ASAP. This way, they'll figure out the next course of action. The doctor will run a series of tests on you. The first will probably be a blood test. They may ask you for a stool sample. If the pain in your midsection is severe, they'll probably put you through some CT scans and ultrasounds. Depending on what your diagnosis is, the doctor will recommend that you fast for a couple days. This gives your pancreas the chance to recover. They'll probably give you some medication to deal with your pain. If you're staying in the hospital during this treatment, doctors will provide you with intravenous fluids. This is because of all the energy you've spent battling the infection. Your body needs a chance to hydrate. If alcoholism is what brought you here, doctors are also known to direct you to programs that help you deal with your addiction. In really extreme cases, surgery will be necessary. This is to remove the infected tissue or drain the excess fluid from your pancreas. If gallstones are causing your pancreas, they may also do surgery to get rid of the gallbladder. Your pancreas is so important, but it's just one of many organs you need to function properly. Have I sparked your interest? Let's keep the conversation going with a couple more videos, shall we? Check out 13 foods that make your kidneys healthy, or how about 9 signs of heart failure you should never ignore? Go ahead and click one, or better yet, watch both, and learn more about how to keep your organs healthy. Have you been experiencing any of the symptoms we talked about? Let us know in the comments below.